welcome to Let's Chat with Curry and Adrian. We are very excited to have you back here on our first new episode in a long time. I'm Curry Terrell. With me, as always,
Adrian McMillan. I don't normally introduce myself, but there we go.
Wow. I'm really just putting you out here.
I guess that's how we're starting. That's okay.
Welcome back, everybody. We're very excited to be back after such a long time.
You know how long it's been?
Okay, the last one we did was Oscar Sunday 2022.
So just about 2 years.
That I don't like to think about it.
That was 336 episodes of Let's Chat that are locked away in the archives until who knows when.
They're in the archives.
One day we'll have a little pay feature where somebody can access them.
I like that.
But who knows?
Who knows? In the vault. It's our vault, our version of the Disney vault.
Yep. They're in the vault.
I love it. The last time we talked, we were watching the Oscars where Will Smith slapped Chris Rock. So if that's how you put it in your brain, it was that long ago.
Yeah. The world has changed since then.
A lot has changed. Yeah. We're totally different people.
In some ways.
We have been changed for good.
For good.
Thank you. Thank you for going there with me. Anyway, we are very excited to be back. For the next couple of weeks, we're going to get right back into things. We're announcing or releasing this on February 18th, which is a big day because it is also the day of...
I have no idea.
American Idol comes back.
Oh, yeah. Nobody watches that except us.
That is not true.
I think it is true.
No.
Yeah.
But this week we're going to talk, sort of get back into our routine, and then the next 2 weeks we're going to bring you all the Oscar movies that are this season leading up to the big Oscar Sunday in March. So we will get you all caught up. We'll tell you what to watch, what not to watch, what you should have watched that wasn't nominated, and all those good things.
Exactly.
But we'll start with, how are you?
I'm tired.
Are you?
I just had a bad sandwich from Jersey Mike's. I don't normally go there. I don't know what told me I should go there. I don't normally, you know this about me. Yeah. I don't like sandwiches, especially like when we go out.
You don't like paying for a sandwich.
No, because I can make a sandwich at home.
Yeah.
It has to be a really special sandwich. So like that place Giada that we went to has delicious chicken salad sandwich. I'm not usually making chicken salad at home. This place, I was like, oh, I don't normally eat Chipotle ranch, whatever.
Chicken.
So I was like, okay. It just tasted like dog food, kind of. Like a dog's breakfast.
You don't like mushy food.
I really don't. And it was hot mush, which is even worse.
I've never gotten that. I always get the Philly.
Yeah, that maybe. But I don't like a Philly cheesesteak either.
Well, something I don't like about Jersey Mike's is the sandwich drips.
Yeah, it's very wet.
But I will say Giada, the sandwich dripped.
Yeah, a little bit.
Also, we got new mics, so you're hearing us better than you have ever heard us before.
Yes, and I'm live directing Curry because he tends to talk away from the microphone.
I move around.
Yeah.
You're
also loud.
Oh, okay.
So we're trying to find this like perfect balance of things because also I'm not an audio engineer, so we're just kind of a rough and tumble team.
You know, when I was in Peter Pan, I'm loud or I'm not facing the mic?
You weren't facing the mic.
Okay, when I was in Peter Pan, they submitted like four or five of us to this commercial for the radio. Mm. And when I got there, the guy made me do it like three or four times. And he said, "Who sent you here?" And pulled me out of the booth.
You got to have that. Ooh, I just hit my microphone. I'm not professional, obviously.
Yes, you are.
You just got to be...
Level. Cool, calm, collected, centered.
Think NPR.
Hello. I don't know what they talk like on NPR. I do not listen to it.
Anyway, how are you doing? I said I'm tired and I had a bad sandwich, so...
I'm fine. I feel fine. I'm scamming them. Let me tell you this. Two big shopping things this weekend.
Okay.
Number one... I got a shot glass from Kelly Clarkson's show by messaging blindly people on Twitter.
Did it come in the mail?
It did not, but he did mail it.
You have the tracking.
I have the tracking.
Okay.
Is it insured? I haven't paid for it.
Oh, right.
So as of now, it's free, which is the best price. Not that expensive. It was not life or death decision, but I just wanted it. It will never be used as a shot glass.
Right.
But I didn't like that it was something people could have that I couldn't have.
Of course.
Number two, I got an Andrew Lloyd Webber record set.
Is that what's right there?
Today.
Oh, yeah.
I paid $8 for
Where?
It. Facebook. Guess what? It's like $120. New.
You
never
got that
been
in the
touched.
Mail?
In the mail. The box is beside me. But I'm not going to grab it because it will make me face a different direction.
So you bought that on Facebook Marketplace. You were looking up Andrew Lloyd Webber
no,
vinyl.
I meant... See, this is not a safe space. No, I was not. And I spiked right
yes,
there.
Yes, you did.
Anyway, so it's been a good day for me, I guess.
Yeah.
My dad is getting hacked, though. That was not a good day.
Yeah, that is also a big update from the last year for me, too. I had my identity stolen. Well,
yeah.
That was recent, too.
I'm still nervous that it's still happening.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know why or when or where. I called the police. I didn't do anything.
What did you do? Did you figure out like what you bought or like put your card?
No.
Yeah.
And you know, during the Super Bowl, which just happened a few days ago,
mm-hmm.
we saw that Temu ad. And my mom was like, oh, that will hack you. And I was like, no, it's fine. You know what I mean? It's like, it's just like any other Amazon like type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Lo and behold. They were like, oh, yeah, you are fully getting your credit cards stolen if you're buying stuff on there. Which I've never purchased anything from there. But I did buy something off of TikTok Shop.
Okay.
My lip plumper.
Okay, so judgment. And do you love it?
It doesn't do anything, really. It's like a lip gloss. But that was really the only thing in recent memory where I had purchased something from a site that like I didn't normally buy stuff from.
How much was it?
Like $25.
That's not that bad. For a cosmetic, no. I feel like.
But I got my identity stolen. So, like, no, that's the ultimate price.
Yeah, that's the price. But it's a little... I ordered something from TikTok Shop.
What was it?
Caroline's slippers.
I don't know what those are.
I got her slippers at Christmas that say Taylor's version.
Oh, yeah. I think you told me that.
And she loved them.
Oh, great.
I was nervous they were going to look like they were from, like,
yeah.
a dungeon.
Yeah.
But they look good.
Yeah.
I was thrilled.
I will not be buying anything else from TikTok Shop.
I also just feel like once you engage with yeah. the TikTok Shop,
yeah.
it's your whole algorithm.
Yeah. People promoting like those $4 vacuums.
Yeah.
No. I don't want it. I don't want it.
Yeah. Okay. We're going to talk about two big things this week as our welcome back party.
What's number one?
Number one, the Grammys.
That's right.
Number two.
The Super Bowl.
The Super Bowl. We're huge sports fans.
And honestly, it was great. I was checking the score during the movie that we were in.
Hold that thought. We're going to start with the Grammys.
Yeah.
We're going to work towards where we are currently today.
Perfect.
The Grammys were last Sunday, mm-hmm. two Sundays ago from when you're listening to this.
Mm-hmm.
And the big winner of the night, Taylor Swift.
She was.
SZA.
She was.
Miley Cyrus.
Yeah, and I saw that it was like one of the first few times, or I guess it was just a time where like women won all the major categories.
I think every televised award was won by a woman.
Which is amazing.
I love that.
Yeah, that's kind of cool.
What I will say about last year's Grammys and this year's Grammys that I have enjoyed.
Mm.
Yes, of course, Renaissance is a better album than Harry's House.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's not really a question. But what I did like about that award ceremony and this award ceremony is the awards they chose to air all had different winners for the most part.
Yeah.
So, yes, like you can disagree about who won what, but like you got to see all of your favorites on the stage
for
at
sure.
some point or another.
For sure.
Like last year, Lizzo won one, Beyonce won one, Harry won one, and they were winning other ones like off the telecast, but they were all getting to make speeches and like have their moment.
Yeah, exactly.
And this year it was nice that it wasn't just like Miley Cyrus won every single award and
I know
she was up there 50 times, but it really was a good night for her.
Now, the collective consensus is that people are tired of Taylor Swift.
Oversaturation.
Which I don't believe. The fandom that she has is not tired of her, and that's what matters.
Exactly.
Sorry.
Yes. Here's why the way I look at the world is like my mom brought up Taylor Swift.
Yeah.
So it has gone to that level of saturation that my mom, who is not watching any of the entertainment shows, she's not on social media in that way, but she knows my mom that Taylor Swift is dating Travis Kelce.
Yeah.
So like, yeah, and so that's just the nature of being famous is like you hit that point of like it's a lot. The tour, all of the albums, but obviously she's that big because she's that big, you know?
It's working out for us. Like, why would she stop?
Exactly. I think now the Super Bowl's over and her tour, even though it's still going, isn't in America right now. I think that will help cool it just a little bit, but then her album comes out.
And it's a brand new album. It's not a re-recorded album.
Are you excited for it?
I am excited. We went to Taylor for the Eras Tour here in Los Angeles, and I loved every second of it.
I had the best time.
Yeah, so I'm always going to listen to the new stuff, and I'm not really listening to the re-recorded stuff.
No.
But new stuff I'll listen to.
If you want to experience the Eras Tour just like we did, our show was the one that was recorded.
And we'll be on Disney Plus.
And it's soon to be on Disney Plus.
Yeah, in March.
Which will not allow password sharing.
So be warned.
So be warned. They're really cracking down on us.
It's sick.
Thank God they haven't got my mom's friendly app that lets me watch the Hallmark Channel.
Just you wait.
They probably will.
Yeah.
Okay, back to the Grammys. Also, wait, one thing about the friendly app. Mm-hmm. They advertised new episodes of Dance Moms on the friendly app, and it is a full Mandela effect moment.
Because you cannot find the show anymore.
It doesn't exist. There is no new season. It was literally her in her current physical state. Mm-hmm. That's I'll leave it there. Mm-hmm. And with kids I had never seen, parents I had never seen, and I was like, oh my gosh, there is new Dance Moms. I was thrilled. And it does not exist. I Googled nothing. So I don't know if it got like put on there early by accident.
No. You should write an email.
My emails go nowhere. I've really learned that recently. They don't go anywhere.
You're a Karen.
I am definitely a Karen. And I'm honestly not upset about it. Sorry. I'm so sorry.
That's okay.
But sometimes you have to fight.
You have to.
Okay, back to the Grammys. What performances stood out to you?
Tracy Chapman.
Unreal.
Joni Mitchell.
Unreal.
Everybody else, I couldn't care less.
I loved the older people.
Yeah.
That's always the fun part about the Grammys that we've sort of gotten away from.
Yeah.
But like Billy Joel, that was cool.
Yeah, but the song's not great.
I like it.
Not for me.
Joni Mitchell was obviously unreal, and she sang the best song.
Of course.
Tracy was unreal. And I'm trying to think who was in the tribute.
I like Miley Cyrus. You don't like Miley Cyrus.
Okay, wow.
I thought she was great.
I like okay, here's the reality.
Yeah.
I do not find her entertaining. I find her to be I don't mean to say grating, but grating. Mm. I think her voice is grating. That era where she was sticking her tongue out is just so ingrained in my brain. That's all I see when I see her. She hasn't acted like that in years.
Yeah.
But there's no denying the songs are good. Mm-hmm. Like, I hear Flowers, I Bop like everybody else. Mm-hmm. It's just I would never pay money for it.
That's really surprising to me.
I know it hurt. When I don't like things that other people like, it hurts me. Like Lana Del Rey, perfect example. You know, it's not just Patrick. You know, she's very famous and has millions and millions of fans.
Yeah.
But, and so I hear it and I'm like, why can't I get into this?
You also like sad music.
I love sad music. So I don't know what it is.
Yeah, I don't know.
But yeah, Miley, but no denying, that song was huge. It deserved every award it won.
Yeah. I kind of like that she's funny.
Yeah.
Like she was up there saying, like, why are you guys acting like you don't know what this song is?
100%.
Did you see the video of her walking the red carpet and she's like, iPhones? Like, why are you guys taking pictures of me with iPhones? Like, so funny, yeah, so she's real. Funny. She's the real deal.
Yeah.
But you don't feel moved by her.
I don't like the sound of her voice. I find very not pleasant.
Now, we have to keep in mind, remember what Tina Fey just said? We're not famous enough to be having our opinions. Or we're too famous to have our opinions.
My real takeaway from that is when she turned to Matt Rogers and said, you're a year away from not being able to say what you feel. He literally had a show on Showtime, an album. He's been in movies.
So we are able to say what we feel because we're not famous yet. We are famous. We're famous. We are or we are not famous.
You tell me.
We are.
You know what? I'll tell Miley to her face.
You don't have a good voice.
I think you have good songs, but you do not have a pleasant voice. I'm sorry.
No, that's right. You know, I did think that it was a mistake to have Dua Lipa open with that song.
I disagree. I thought that was probably the best award show performance she's ever had. Mm. And it was fun watching her get lifted on that thing.
It was just silly.
Okay. I will say, again, last year and this year, there is something they need to figure out with not getting the big names to perform. Last year, Renaissance was the big album. Beyonce did not perform. Right. Taylor did not perform. This year, and Adele last year didn't perform. This year, Taylor didn't perform. Yeah. It's like they need to be on the stage. It's the Grammys.
Yeah.
Also, Fantasia.
She was great.
And I rewatched it at home. Obsessed. She killed it.
That has been added to the YouTube repertoire.
That has been added to the repertoire. At first, I thought when I saw her come out, I said, she's not the right person for Proud Mary. Mm-hmm. Vocally, she's the right person for anything. But like the dancing, she's not who I think about.
But she killed it. She killed it. Her own version, which I like.
Exactly.
You can't beat that.
Absolutely loved it.
Now, we can't not talk about the Grammys or talk about the Grammys and not talk about Taylor and Celine, which I have told you now four times. Blown out of proportion.
I've softened as the 2 weeks have gone on.
Yeah.
But not really. Taylor, I understand the moment's huge. There's a million things going on. Yeah. I doubt she was like,
I'm going to rip this out of Celine Dion's hand.
Yeah. There was something not cute about her taking an award from anyone and not looking at them, but much less the fact that it was Celine Dion making her grand return to the public after all her health stuff. And Taylor was just like, thanks.
But again, can we judge her for something that she that she did not make a conscious decision of? Like it was just
no.
Or can we judge her more because it felt so second nature?
Both.
I'm a psychologist.
Two things can be true.
Yeah.
I can be upset that she took the award. I'm sorry, I spiked. Two things can be true. I'm sorry that she took the my brain just went eight directions. Two things can be true. I can be upset that Taylor took the award out of Celine Dion's hand without acknowledging that I just took an award out of Celine Dion's hand. Yeah. Thank you for being alive.
Right.
And also, I can understand it's a huge moment.
Yeah.
And we are overanalyzing everything that she does.
Right. My question to you is, would you have judged her as hard if it was XYZ?
No, because that XYZ wouldn't have just walked out to a huge standing ovation making their huge public moment after having a health battle. Also, it is Celine Dion. Even if she was just out on a Tuesday, the way Miley acted to Mariah, that's how she should have acted.
Yeah.
It is Celine Dion.
Right.
It doesn't matter who you are, what genre you sing, she is like one of the greatest that ever was.
I think people blew it out of proportion.
For sure.
Including you.
Yeah, I did. I absolutely did. But did I post about it anywhere?
No.
I just talked to you about it.
But you'll hold it against her. Forever.
Okay. It's like Avril Lavigne and Kelly.
Mm-hmm.
When Kelly was at the VMAs, when American Idol was still on, before she had won, it was her and Justin. They presented Best New Artist to Avril Lavigne. Avril Lavigne tried to wiggle out of the hug with Kelly when she presented her with the award.
Wasn't Avril Lavigne like 12?
Okay. So, do I forgive her? Yes. But is it always in my mind a little bit?
Yeah. So, you're always going to judge her for that?
Avril?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's honestly a revelation.
Sorry. Well, also, you know, Kelly is... That's like a no-go for me. There's a man yesterday that commented yesterday talking about how you didn't like Usher, and then which is absurd. And then under it, he wrote, what's next year? Kelly Clarkson...
And what, you commented?
I unfriended him. No, I didn't unfriend him. What's the thing where you can, like, on Facebook, but still be friends? I unfollowed him. I don't want to see it ever again.
Who was it?
Some man that I went to church with years ago.
Kelly Clarkson.
As what? That's a bad thing? And I was doing that thing where I type and delete, and I was like, I can't do this. I can't be fighting with people I don't talk to about Kelly on Facebook.
Wow.
I'm sick.
Mentally ill.
I'm mentally ill.
Who would I go to bat for like that? No one.
Me. No, you wouldn't. I know you wouldn't.
I don't like involving myself online.
And I don't either, and I try not to. Only when
especially for somebody who, like, at the end of the day...
doesn't know you.
Well, not even that. Like, she's not looking. Like, she doesn't know that...
literally doesn't even have social media on her phone.
That's what I'm saying.
But it hurts me.
You don't like that other people will then read that and read it about her.
Exactly. Same with Leanne Rimes.
Yeah.
And Leanne Rimes, I've actually commented more for her because I know she sees it.
Yeah.
And not that she sees me fighting. She sees people saying bad stuff.
Yeah.
That hurts me.
Yeah. That's insane.
I need help. anything else you want to say about the Grammys?
No.
I had a fun time with them.
It felt too long.
The one thing that I think... hurt the timing of it was those little packages.
Yeah.
We need to cut those.
Yeah, of course.
Like the Emmys, we need to cut some of those tributes.
Yeah.
And then we're cutting people's speeches. Yeah. It can't be both.
Right.
Victoria Monet, she was also, I'm glad she won.
There you go.
Did you see when they showed her on the Jumbotron at the Super Bowl? Ariana was like, they're here too.
Uh-uh.
With Cynthia Erivo and her.
Uh-uh.
Love.
That's nice.
Super Bowl.
I loved it.
We love football.
We watched a lot of football.
More than we've ever watched. I will say we left 3/4 of the way through the game to go watch Dreamgirls at the Academy Museum.
You can't beat that.
Which was the right choice for us and for anyone.
Yeah.
I was sad knowing I had missed all the good stuff in the game.
Me too.
And I was like, I should not be feeling this way about football.
That's okay. We're invested.
We are a little more invested because we've watched more of it with your brother.
Exactly. But ultimately, it still felt exciting, even watching the pieces that we did, where, like, not a lot happened, but enough happened.
The first part that we watched where the score was, like, 3-10 was so boring.
It was boring.
Football in general, you watch people move 5 yards,
right,
and then you go to commercial.
Yeah, and you know one quarter takes, like, 45 minutes to an hour and a half.
That's not fun. And especially like Super Bowl Sunday, the commercials are fun.
Yeah.
Normal games, it's the same 10 commercials over and over.
Yeah. For like Kia.
I don't get it. That I don't get. No. That's like, yeah. But it was fun. I had a good time. Usher, what'd you think?
It was a good performance. Of course, you can't beat Alicia Keys starting out terribly. Like you, at the end of the day, speaking of social media, I wonder if she knows that people judge her so hard for the fact that she can't sing live.
1,000%.
And maybe she sings live, like, well, 45% of the time, 50% of the time. But it's bad when, like, we're all, like, waiting at the edge of our seat. And then the first note out of your mouth is bad.
We rewound it 100 times. We gasped.
And they edited it out of the YouTube video.
Obsessed with that. Yeah,
that's crazy.
It's
misinformation. It's Mandela effect.
I know.
Like, what else are they editing out from us?
You're right.
Conspiracy theory.
Yeah, it's true. Lay it out. Lay it out right here. I will say that one video where she screams and throws her head back, and that will haunt her for the rest of her life.
Forever.
No matter what. It's just tough because it's the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
So like
it was the most like watched telecast since the moon landing.
But I do love that she got to sing that song.
Yeah.
It's her best song.
Yeah. Who else did he bring out? Will.i.am, Jermaine Dupri, her.
My mom said, who is the man in the capris?
Jermaine Dupri. Dupri. Jermaine Dupri capri. I swear.
I said, are you watching this? She said, yes, it's fun. And she said she didn't mind Alicia's note. She said she thought she was great.
Wow.
And she loved her piano.
It was a pretty piano.
The roller skating of it all.
Of it all.
Oh, sorry. Roller skating? Excellent. That's my new phrase that I have to work on. Of it all.
Season one, remember it was camp.
Camp. Everything is camp.
Very campy. Very campy. Now it's of it all.
Help me.
I like the roller skating. Did you see that thing where the girl fell, apparently?
Yes. Did you see the girl fall off the stripper pole?
Yeah.
Did you see the guy get thrown up in the air and then nobody knew where he landed?
Yeah.
I mean, that is my kind of humor. I was giggling in my bed like a schoolgirl. Watching those.
Yeah, that is crazy.
No, I loved the roller skating. That's what I'm saying. I loved it.
So that girl said that she lied on her resume. For some reason, I think that's fake.
Okay. Do you remember a couple weeks ago when we were sitting on this very couch?
Yeah.
And I said to you, there's a girl who's an assistant mm-hmm. at the Grammys and she got fired. Mm-hmm. It's mm-hmm. the same girl. It's fake.
So it's just planted?
Like she's just making stuff up. She's doing stuff for viral videos.
But is she hired from CBS?
I don't know.
Like to make viral content?
I don't know. But also that black eye or whatever was...
It looked like...
It looked like I did it.
Yeah.
In makeup class. Like it was...
It reminds me of those moments... Like you remember when that girl was doing the handstand and then she fell on the candle and it ended up being a Jimmy Kimmel sketch?
Yeah.
It reminds me of that.
I fell for one of those this very week. Mm-hmm. We were... I was scrolling through TikTok and they had an ad for that show about the hiker.
Yeah.
Saying... Oh, yeah. HBO Max took this down because it was too controversial. Mm-hmm. They didn't.
That was fake.
And I watched it because I was like, oh, they're going to take it down. Or like, what did they do? I fell for the scam.
But you watched it on HBO Max.
Yeah.
Even though they said it was taken down.
Yeah. I immediately looked and it was there. I put it on my list before because it was true crime, which you know, I love.
So you watched it thinking it had been taken down, but it was somehow magically on yours.
Well, it's like, no. Well, I thought like maybe it hasn't been taken down yet, so I need to like get through it.
Fascinating.
Okay, we're learning. Let's talk about you. Okay, Usher.
Yeah,
he did a great job. I thought also he has so many good songs.
Bop after bop.
Bop after bop. He can still dance. He sounded good when he was ducking out of a lot of the songs,
yeah.
And I was like, oh, okay, so this is how you like operate your. At this stage yeah. of your life. But then when he stood still, he was throwing notes like crazy. So I was like, oh, you still can really sing.
Yeah. Now, off the halftime show, did you see that people were thinking that Taylor was doing a drinking game every time she showed up on the screen?
I didn't see it.
That makes me laugh.
Was she drunk?
I don't think she was drunk, but like you can see like the second they cut to her, she would take a shot.
Did you love that video where Lana Del Rey gets jumped on?
Hilarious.
I watched that on loop.
Did she actually hurt her arm?
No.
She was. Somebody said she was in a sling.
I don't know. Ask Patrick.
Oh, well, Patrick?
Patrick, if you're listening, text Adrian yes.
Or no.
Y for yes or N for no. Reba did great.
She was good.
You can just say she did great.
She was good. Malone was okay.
Post Malone was fine.
Andre Day was great.
Andre Day, I mean, of course. Yeah. Not even a question. And the choir behind her, unreal.
And you said out loud that I discovered her.
You did. You played me Rise Up on Larchmont Boulevard. Mm-hmm. Is that a boulevard?
Yeah, I think so.
And then like 6 months later, it was in the Apple commercial.
Yeah.
You discovered. I give you full credit. Same with, what's that girl?
Remy Wolf.
You discover her. And then like a year later, Alex Moss was like, have you ever heard of this girl? And I was like, you're late. Adrian's been on this.
Ground level.
Literally from A1 Day 1.
Now, did you see that they're already predicting who's in the Super Bowl next year? Because of the colors of the logo.
No.
That's a thing.
Oh, like the teams, you mean?
Yes.
Well, I wouldn't know. Did you? Yeah, you go.
It's all rigged. People think it's all rigged.
I don't believe that.
They think that the colors predict who is in the Super Bowl, which doesn't make sense because this year it was like red and purple. The other team wasn't purple. Neither of the teams Chiefs? Were purple. The Chiefs are red.
No, in the one next year.
No. Well, people think it could be. Of course, they have a good quarterback. I'm a sports person.
I love sports. Especially when we watch the random ones, like on Sundays, cornhole.
Yeah.
Axe throwing.
Bowling.
And the sponsors are like corn nuts.
Yeah.
It's like, what? I love those.
Yeah, those are fun.
That's like a whole subculture, like Cook's Country.
Mm-hmm. Who knows? If you're listening to this and know about Cook's Country, or actually, I mean, if I say the next word, you probably know what that is, which is America's Test Kitchen. But Cook's Country and America's Test Kitchen like are under the same like umbrella.
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
Oh.
But Cook's Country is the show.
Okay.
/ like magazine newsletter type of thing, and then America's Test Kitchen is like the overarching thing that holds all of these little companies underneath it. But you love Cook's Country.
I do enjoy it when I watch it. I also like how short it is.
Patrick calls it an infomercial.
It feels like an infomercial. I think it's the way they're dressed and the way like the room is lit.
Yeah, yeah. But they are supposed to give like unbiased factual information because they're not getting sponsored by anybody, by exactly. any one company.
And that's why they're dressed that way, because exactly. they want to be like, it's not about us, it's about the food.
Exactly right.
I love that.
Yeah.
And they all seem nice.
You can watch it on YouTube or the PBS app.
The PBS app.
Or on PBS.
Any Super Bowl commercials that stuck out to you?
Dunkin'.
That was the best one, I thought.
Dunkin' was really funny. The Beyonce one.
You saw Jennifer Lopez said she was retiring after this, or she wasn't making any more albums.
Good.
What do you feel?
Good.
I think we really need to talk about, in general, not just you and me in this. I mean, in general, she really, people are too hard on her.
Maybe.
She has given us a lot of really good songs
yeah.
and really fun movies that we still watch.
Yeah. But I think they're, maybe in the same respect that Taylor's like, are you a singer? Like, what are, like, are you an entertainer? You are entertaining.
Yeah.
But I don't know that I think of her as a singer.
No, but I'm not buying a jazz album. She's singing, I Want to Dance Again. And I'm like, me too. Right. Get on the floor. I'm like, okay. I'm sorry. Yeah. Nobody on this earth is like, I heard Jan on the Block and didn't like it.
No, of course. She definitely has hits.
And it's not even, it's like, anyway. Beyonce was unreal.
We have Act Two coming finally.
The, like, perfect moment of after Usher finished, y'all thought that broke the internet. Mm-hmm. Guess what we're about to do in the commercial? Mm-hmm. Little fake commercial. Mm-hmm. Unreal.
And then the music didn't drop immediately.
The music didn't drop immediately, which was so funny.
When she uttered the words, okay, y'all, they're ready. Drop the new music. Live.
In that second, it should have been, we should have all been getting dings on our phone.
Notifications, Apple new Music, Beyonce new song. Beyonce music, Spotify, Pandora, whatever.
You had to download Tidal in the car so we could listen to them.
Yeah, because it was only available there for the time being.
They're both excellent.
Very, very, very good songs.
16 Carriages, the first time I heard it in the car, I thought, this is not a single, this is an album track.
Yeah.
But then when I listened to it yesterday and like really listened to the words, I was like, this is a bop.
I know.
Just about her legacy.
Wild.
She gets it.
Yeah,
she does. She really gets it.
I know. I'm very excited. And it's a stacked year for music.
Oh, yeah.
So it's going to be her with the country, Lana with the country, Lady Gaga, apparently, Taylor.
Dua Lipa. What is wrong with you and Dua Lipa? She gives us bops.
I like Physical. That's the last song I liked of hers. And the song from Barbie. I like her.
I'm rolling my eyes. You can't see it because it's a podcast, but they're rolled. Casey.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm trying to think of somebody else, but it's not coming to me.
No.
Okay.
That's right.
Also, the best part of the Super Bowl, the Wicked trailer.
Yeah. I will watch it, but it didn't do anything for me.
Shockingly. It's a lot of green screen.
Yeah.
For, especially knowing they built all those sets, and then the trailer is like 90% green screen, that did hurt my feelings a little bit.
Yeah.
But I don't care. I do not care. I watched you know how you watch reaction videos about stuff? That's literally what I did in bed until like 3 a.m. the other night.
Reactions to Wicked.
The Wicked trailer.
That's surprising.
Every Broadway account I follow was like, here's our beat by beat reaction.
Yeah.
Love.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, I'll be there.
And you know they're going to kill it with the music. Mm-hmm. Do you think they'll have a concert at the Hollywood Bowl? The two of them and sing all the songs?
No.
But Can I Dream?
Yeah.
Okay, well, should we leave with our songs of the week?
I don't have one.
Yes, you do. You said in the card, this is going to be my song of the week.
I couldn't even tell you what it is.
Well, I'll give you a hint. We just spoke of it 1 second ago.
Oh, yeah. 16 Carriages by Beyonce.
That's not even what you said. You said the other one first.
Sixteen carriages driving away while I watch them ride with my dreams away to the summer sunset on a holy night on a long black road. All the tears I fight. 16 carriages driving away while I watch them ride with my dreams away to the summer sunset on a holy night on a long black road. All the tears I fight.
I'm leaving. I'm going home, Mr. Mother.
I think I love both, but 16 Carriages made me cry when I listened to it again by myself. So that's what I'm going to go with. What about you?
Deeper Well, Casey Musgraves.
My Saturn has returned. When I turned 27, everything started to
to change. Took a long time, but I learned there's two kinds of people. One is a giver, the one's always trying to take all they can take. So I'm saying goodbye to the people that I feel are real good at wasting my time. No regrets, baby, I just think that maybe you go your way and I'll go mine. It's been a real good time.
It's a good one.
Can't wait for her album.
Yeah, it's good.
Okay, so just a reminder, next week and the week after, we're going to break down all the Oscar movies for you, split in half, so you don't have to just listen to us talk for hours and hours. And then after that, we will be coming to you on the day of Super Bowl, amen, Oscar Sunday.
Yeah.
And we'll tell you everything about it. We can't wait to have y'all join us again. We're very excited you're back. We've missed you a ton, and we hope that you have missed us too.
What a great outro. Bye, y'all.
Bye. Thank you so much for listening to Let's Chat with Curry and Adrian. If you enjoyed the show, and we know you did, subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you listen. Don't forget to leave a 5-star review. Keep the conversation going by following me on Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter at Curry Terrell, and Adrian on Instagram at Adrian McMill, and Twitter at Yo Adrian McMill. Discover our weekly song picks by adding our playlist on Spotify or Apple Music, all linked in this week's episode description. Got questions or feedback? Email us at letschatwithcurry@gmail.com. See you next time. Bye, y'all.